So I am able to give you results of Nemaha County and Marshall County and the advanced votes. I can't get from the clerk the results of the three polling places. So in the advanced votes, you have 39 yes advanced votes and 38 no.
Where?
That's all the advanced voting, both counties.
Oh.
Yeah.
That was about 38.
Because that would have been a total of almost 89.
I thought that was Nemaha County, she had her vote in there.
I'll double check.
Okay.
I'll double check.
We'll add this up.
If that's the case, that's like 70 on just the Nemaha County side, so she had a bunch of advanced voting.
39, 38.
39 to 38, 39 yes, 38 no. The thing I need to find out for you all, if that's just on the Nemaha County side or if that was the total. The next number she gave me was the yes votes on the Nemaha side at the actual polling places, Corning and Centralia put together, and that was 149 yes to 246 no. And then, Marcel, now you have me confused.
Yeah, I think that was total.
The Frankfurt side then is 69 yes votes, 350 no votes. Total, all three polling places, 263 yes votes, 698 no votes.
263 and what?
698.
Yeah, so that's where I was.
So what I am actually just wanting to have some conversation about this evening is a couple of things to keep in mind. November would not cost you anything to run that election. So a little conversation about, are you interested in running it again in November? Incredible voter turnout, very impressed with the voter turnout, so that was pleased with that.
Did they have a percentage? Did they give a percentage of what the actual turnout was?
She did not. She did not. So if you were to run it again, do you want to run the same thing? Do you want to run something different? Are you interested in running it at all? So that's the conversation I'd like to have a few minutes around. I got some information from Zach on breaking down prices and whatnot, so if you have questions about that, I'm happy to share that with you as well. We can talk more about what's in that email.
Did everyone get their email that she sent today?
Okay.
The one with tags?
A couple copies too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
When do we have to announce that we're going to do it in November?
She has not gotten back to me with that, the county clerk. I asked her, and here's the deal. If you don't go above 14% of the district's debt limit, then you can run the election again without having to go through the state board process again. So if we were to come under or stay right around $5 or $6 million, Dustin and I talked about that, anything $5 or $6 million puts you within that 14% of your, doesn't exceed your
debt. So this has to go back to the...
It does not have to go back to KSDE if it's under that 14%.
What does that mean?
It gives you about $5 or $6 million. It takes that out of the process.
Days.
Time, days, time.
Yeah, it's a process.
Yeah, yeah. So basically the only time frame you're under is, like Scott said, how soon would the county clerk need to have those election documents written up from Dustin so she can create the ballot. She's got a lot more on that ballot with school board elections and whatnot. Stay under 14% of your assessed valuation, right? There you go.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Did you, I guess Larry, you know, when you guys doubled up on the fax room at Centralia, did they put a washer dryer in there?
No.
Because I know that was one of the requirements there.
So I'm kind of excited for you all to go for the September meeting in Centralia because we've repainted in there and they've done quite a bit of work. Hot water heaters are in there. We've told and talked about the fact that Larry and Claire are just going to spend a little time in that room. Is Claire a new teacher and whatever items that she thinks she needs, we need to, because I know that was a priority for the board, that room, so.
I don't see any reason running it the same as with this result.
Right.
It definitely needs to change.
I would agree.
I mean, safety and security is the main thing, so. We run that on all three buildings. Take 3Ks out of both buildings, we'll leave them in here at Vermillion.
So your Vermillion cost that was shared is $134,000. I talked with Zach Moore today. That can probably be cut in half. There's no need to do the kind of work that you would do on that north side that you would want to do on the south side. So he talked like that could come down to probably 60 or 70. You all had originally talked about that cost coming out of capital outlay and not being a part of the bond.
And I think we should maintain that.
Would you like to see my idea?
I would love to hear your idea.
There's actually the Dean of Larry's. Now, a lot of this, I'm sure there's going to be things where somebody's going to point something out that I didn't cover. So it's just a rough draft. But I think, like you said, Sarah, with the amount of negativity in it, I mean, we've got to do something right.
Agreed.
I mean, I honestly don't think anything over $3 million is going to pass on freight. Right or wrong, I'm not saying that's right, I'm not saying it's wrong, I'm just saying that's what I feel by the number. So what I was thinking about was, like it says here, just the safety for the bond part of itself, the safety and security of Frankfurt Centurion, and that would be the key access and stuff. I added that up with the figures that Michelle gave me today, and that would be like $1,195,000. And that's the card key access and everything. That's the numbers that we got today. Okay. Then, and I don't know, on the factoring, Larry, that's not, I mean, like you said, if that's an ongoing project, I don't know if we need to make that part of the bond or not. I don't know how much you have to do in there.
I don't think it'd have to be part of the bond.
Yeah, I mean, are you talking 50,000 or less?
Yeah, I mean, it's...
So if it's, I mean, to me, if it's 50,000 or less, and I think it's probably less than that, probably 25 or less,
right.
Maybe. We can easily do that out of capital outlay as a summer project next year, or a little bit as the year goes on. Okay, so the black trim's not going to be in the bond. Then, as far as moving Dusty around, and in order to get something for the art, to make the art room nicer, my idea is move Dusty downstairs to that biology room, move the art room out there, and then put in the bond, or have Zach figure out what it would take to put in a patio deal on the outside. And again, that may be dollars that we can spend out of capital outlay, but we don't want to hammer capital outlay too long, because we still have our other projects we have to do. I mean, our heating and air and all that, we want to stay on pace and keep those things in line. So you can make whatever dollars it would take. And I know one time I talked to Zach, and he said it'd be very minimal to make that an art room, because you already have your water in it, you already have your electricity there and everything. So find out what it would take to renovate that into an art room. And that, then we have a nice new space for that. Mm-hmm. At least they're not down there in a hole like they are. Then the storage part of Larry, and this is where I'll have to ask you, if that would open up that old art room for storage like we had talked about for the janitors, a place to get their mower in and work on stuff, would that give enough storage space that we could go ahead and take that west wall out of the weight room? Or are you still going to need part of that for storage?
We'd have to look and see. You know, a lot of that stuff is PE.
Right. That's in that storage room now?
It's in the storage room.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I didn't know what was in there, and that's my question.
Yeah, we'd have to look and see what we all have. And
I don't know if you could gain any room that way.
There's tables in there that we use for the new game.
Right.
Yeah, volleyball stuff in there.
Yeah, volleyball stuff and ping pong tables and
things like that
he brings out to the gym.
Right.
Needs to have access.
Right. So maybe that's not an option to really help the weight room. I don't know. But it's just an idea. That's why I didn't talk to Larry today. It just was part of my deal. So then moving on from there, then we're talking about what Michelle just said. I had her call Zach today about that safety and security here, because that dollar figure seemed way high.
It's way too high.
And I was like, what are we doing? Well, that was for every room. Well, we don't need to lock all the rooms up north, we don't even use them. And like I told her, we secure this entrance here, and then we lock the south wing up, because the door lock's going up that much. You know, and you can either put that in the bond or take it out of the bond. I mean, that's whatever you wanna do. If we can get that in there for $60,000 or less, we can probably squeeze that out of capital outlay.
Because y'all should go look, you know, on capital outlay here, you almost need to look at doing breaker panels and.
Yeah, if you wanna go ahead and do the breaker panels pretty soon, you know, the next year after that or something, I mean, so you may wanna make the safety and security here out of the bond, I don't know. I don't know. That's something that you can move.
So Keith, can I talk about that art room and science room just a little bit? Larry and I talked today, and went over and walked through and whatnot. One of the thing, and I talked to Joni. Joni was on the Frankfurt side today, so I visited with her a little bit. She is not, she's gonna make great art in that room or whatever space we give her, obviously. Her biggest concern, Larry's biggest concern in that room is extension cords spread all over everywhere. On the Frankfurt side, she gets those electrical opportunities from above, whereas right now everything's on the ground.
But wouldn't you make that part of the bond though?
Yeah, I just wonder.
Can we do that?
Yeah, but one of the things that, I think it was Zach on one of the walkthroughs that we had, coming in to, by Roger and Jason's room, they talked about reconfiguring all of that, leaving her art room down there. Now the storage space we didn't, you and I didn't talk about today. But reconfiguring and remodeling that space down there so that you were, that stairway that turns, make it, he talked about like an incline or something, somehow so that you would go and open up that space where that stairwell is and keep her down there instead of, that, because that, partly because that science room is a lovely space as it is. It's a really good science space right now. So I don't know if maybe, and maybe that would be less expensive to just renovate down there, but it doesn't answer your space issue. Like you were talking storage.
Well, I mean, I just, to me, that art room looks like a hole.
Yeah, I don't, sorry.
To me, but I mean, if they're there, I don't have to be there, so what's their decision?
I haven't had a conversation with Joni yet, but Carl Brothers did approach me about it. And he said that, you know, he hates to see it move because they can back a truck right there and unload everything, then you done it.
Oh, okay.
If you move it up, they've got to haul it all, they got to find people to haul it all the way down into the room. You know, that was some of his concerns, and.
Well, it's back in by the dumpsters though, up there, and we can make it.
Yeah, which is a good part of the line, yeah.
But I think originally, he, you know, he was looking at it when we was moving into the old gym.
Oh, I see.
And there was no way to get a truck.
No way to get it there, yeah, that's a good point.
But this would be a good, you know, another option.
And what, Larry, we didn't talk about storage today. When you and I were talking about, we were trying to prioritize some of the things as well, and didn't talk about the storage.
Well, if the, well, then another option may be if that's another appendage on the outside, but if you wanted to add a weight room, put a weight room on the south side of the gym.
We talked about adding on the art room, we tried to extend that 10 or 15 feet, you know.
Because when I talked to her, she just.
Well, he said for the cost, he says, you know, it's not the greatest thing to do, but, you know, it would work.
Well, originally we talked about taking that towards the street.
But the art room or the.
He's talking about taking it to the north, I think, isn't he?
The art room?
Yeah.
To the west.
To the west.
Towards the street.
Because when I talked to her a little bit, she just, her biggest concern was she wanted more locker room space for the kids.
Storage. Her art storage, that's
yes.
All. Yeah.
Because she said really there's no place, not very much space in there for her. She seemed really happy with where she was at. She just would like to have a little more storage space.
Just some clutter, because it's just so.
There's not room to put anything.
Nowhere to put anything.
And she said she didn't need a lot more room, but she said it would be nice to have a little more, just a little more space.
And then the updating of it, so.
Okay. Well, then if that's the case, then I guess that's part of my.
What about the ag classroom?
How much you can do with it.
I know, that's the concern. That's where I'm going.
You mean with the noise?
The noise. It's not really conducive to.
Is there any way to
effective learning?
Insulate it more to just cut down on the noise, or?
I don't know, maybe you should try that, or I'm sure there's insulation up in there, but.
sometimes they have that noise canceling stuff, but a little bit better stuff you can put in the ceiling.
Probably a little tough to get up there without taking that drop ceiling clear down and redoing it though.
They make some of those tiles that are sound deadening.
So Keith, when you were going through this in your mind, any interest in looking at remodeling that older gym? Like we kind of did in here with this one, when you all had the rain shear or whatever that came through with Larry, and I talked a lot about that today.
Yeah, I mean, we all know it's unsafe. I mean, period, it's unsafe. You know, we know that. You know, but if that's all we have, then can we renovate the old gym? You know, make it at least where the plaster's not falling off, the ceilings, tiles not falling down.
Yeah. I mean, to keep it as a gym.
Yeah, absolutely.
You're going to use it as a gym.
Well, I mean, we got no choice.
Right.
We'll have to do something.
These are just.
But you're talking probably.
Rough draft.
Well, what he's saying, even if you were to do a new gym, he'd want to go ahead and get this more presentable, is that what you're saying?
Well, presentable.
If we're not.
It just looks like.
Safety wise.
Yeah.
No,
it's the same space.
Until then.
You're not going to do that safety wise.
No,
presentable, nice, you know, skim the walls so they're straight and they've got some nice, I don't know what they put on walls, probably gymnasium stuff, I'm sure they've got some on the side of the walls, the ceiling needs to be sheetrocked, I don't know why they did sheetrock that years ago, they put the tile in there.
I think it's because of the sound.
Well,
cheap.
I thought it was because of the sound.
Silent.
Because it was so noisy.
So,
tiles
but
are,
yeah, I mean, yeah, that's.
I mean, that's an option.
Absolutely.
I would like to see. I mean, if we're going to keep that old gym as a gymnasium, if that's what the community wants, then I think we need to put some money into it. That's what we're going to use.
I would agree.
To update this gym.
And we're not looking for solid things tonight. Just having a good conversation, maybe a more solid plan, more team, or even on the 28th. So, another concern on your last paragraph, elementary classes above 25. I see. So what you're saying?
Well,
is,
what I'm saying is, if we're not going to change, if we're not going to put classrooms in the old gym, so we don't have
space.
We have no extra classrooms. So we've talked about that in the last 2-3 years. Mm-hmm. What are we going to do when we run into that class of 30, 32, 28? Where are we going to draw that line? What are we going to do? One of the options is if we don't have any more space, we'll have to hire another teacher or more age or whatever. However, you know, like I said, each class is unique. I mean, some classes, one teacher can teach with 2 aides. Some classes may need more instruction and they may need 2 full-time teachers. That's something that each board will have to cross. The administrators will have to decide with all from all the teachers to say, well, this is what I think we need and that's what the board's going to have to support. And the board's just going to have to say, all right, we have to hire a teacher.
You're saying teacher in the same, 2 teachers in the same classroom.
If that's what it takes. I mean, like I said, you may have a class that just has a lot of kids, but everything works out real good, and that class is pretty easy to handle, and the teacher may say, you know, if I can do it, if I have some plenty of help. But if you hire 2 aides, you're almost the same dollar as another teacher, so I mean, it might be a wash. You know, I think you just have to take it. Case by case basis, and every class is different, and we'll go from there. If we're not going to have the extra space, we don't have an extra room to split them into, and that's really our only other option.
We don't have any choice.
Right. That's the way I see it. These are just my thoughts.
Other thoughts, suggestions? Because I'd like to give Michelle some directive.
Yes.
Getting information.
Well, I'd say we can kind of see the exact area over here, look at that gym and see what we can do to kind of renovate it. What's there?
And maybe that's to have him come back and propose a renovation for that art room or what have you, as compared to switching the 2 rooms around.
Yeah, that's what I need to interrupt. It's a nice science lab. It's nice size. The one downstairs is smaller. We step down. You know, so science classes, which, you know, he has 20-some-plus kids in there, you know, it's a little bit small. You know, but that's, you know, we still don't get it.
So I think what I hear...
Options are open.
just an idea.
Yeah, and what I think I hear you guys saying is take off the additional Frankfurt early childhood piece, take off the Centralia piece. If in time we would need that on either space, we could look at that then.
Figure it out then.
Figure it out then. So I will ask Zach to come in and look at some of those things with us again, so we have some a little bit better idea. I don't know if I'll be in here by Monday the 14th or not, but I can try. We'll also talk about the insulation between the gym and the ag room, if there's something that can be done there to protect some sound or increase the sound.
I mean, it's the way it sounds to me, that we're not going to get close to $5 or $6 million. That is with the amount of known folks we have.
Right.
It's almost, hate to say it, if we were sitting here with a 50-boat difference, we'd really stretch our heads. If you run it again the same way, lose 50 more, where do you gain this 50, or how do you not lose, you know, nothing? That's what it is.
And you wanted a percentage from county.
I was just curious what the percentage of turnout was.
I think that was in the Marysville Advocate, if I'm not mistaken. I've got that paper out in the car. I can go get it. I thought they gave the percentages in the Marysville Advocate. But I could be mistaken. It seemed like it was 45% or something.
Anything else? Michelle,
we'll
get some information on. No? Okay, we'll move on.
Well, what about, sorry. So is there any, so I guess if you're using that, that janitor storage is pretty full, but it's not really going to help the room.
No.
The only way to help the weight room would be,
you'd have to move your own weight, that storage.
I'd have to look and see what's on that.
Is that
either?
It might be cheaper to build a storage room.
Well, I was just going to say, you need to build a storage room.
Tough shit out there.
I know.
Or not necessarily that.
Another shit.
Another shit. Yeah, let's just go.
We got another color brick on here.
Shipping container.
Yeah, we got it.
Sure, we can find it. If we don't have green yet, do it. We can put green or something on there. Green. That's something different.
Yeah, we could. I mean, I'd rather see that just so we can take stuff off that museum on that corner. You know, put stuff in the end. If we want to say,
yeah, you could have your Zach's room. You guys can talk to Zach and see what he thinks about adding somewhere. Something that wouldn't. Problem is, you add another building somewhere, then down the road,
it's in the way.
In 5 or 6, 7 years, another board comes in here, whoever the only board, and they, you know, no people get behind us. We're going to build a gym, and then it's going to be sitting right in the road.
Well, if you put it where the plan showed,
out south,
south, you know,
then you still, it'd still be
that.
Still,
on
that road.
Yeah,
that's right.
Yeah.
52
Nemaha,
45 Marshall. Need to look it up. Big building.
Unless you want to talk to Zach about it, just get a cost. Either a day or nay. You got to develop. So if you put storage
somewhere there, to put it.
Just something to help the weight room that you want to expand.
If you move that wall in there, so you don't need some extra space. If you move that wall in there,
So
you gain your storage back.
You're
short storage, right?
South.
Because the weight room is basically nothing but a brick four walls. It's four walls. It's no different than storage rooms. Why don't we just build a new weight room on the south side of the gym?
You got a lot attached to the gym.
Yeah, but you get all the stuff you got stored there, you can get into that weight room.
Rock climbing looks out there.
Well, I know. Again, the stigma of sports. papers. They probably vote for a storage room, and then what? It's all still.
Make it a storage room. Make it a storage room.
Would it be better to leave the weight room where it's at?
Just trying to get here.
Yeah, just, I mean, it's.
It's not.
It's still the room.
Yeah, it's.
We're just gonna build a room.
Build a room.
Just a room.
Build a place.
Just a room. Have we addressed everything? Thank you.
That helps me, I'll get all of Zach and go from there.
Okay. Moving on, early childhood development updates. Good news, we have on the Frankfurt side, 13 families paid for morning three-year-old programming with one more possible tomorrow evening coming in. Tomorrow evening's our three-year-old preschool open house. We have five on the Centralia side fully paid right now, with 10 more who made contact and called and have said we'll be here tomorrow night and we'll get our money in tomorrow. So, 10 more, so we could have 14 and 15 right now. So, yeah, it is, that's about what we, where we thought we'd be, a little less.
A lot.
Yeah, it's not a lot. We thought we'd have 17, I think, in the morning, and we're at 14.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, in the afternoon, probably was a little more than what we've got in so far, but. Yep. Yes, that is included in those reduced rates too. And our children with IEPs as well.
Is this, I know we had talked about before, out of district students. I know you have a couple of.
You said no.
If they're three-year-olds and they want to pay, we know them.
And we have room.
At what point can come down to transportation too? They want to.
Well, they'll have to transport them.
I suppose if you want me to offer it.
One's here today.
Do what?
One's right here today.
Yeah. If you want me to amend that a little bit or think about that, as long as they're willing to do the transportation.
Well, I say, after you have your enrollment night tomorrow night, if there's spots available and they're willing to transport their children, why not?
If he's here with 20 kids, I'd say no.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
But this is, I think it's changed a little bit because, to me, I feel it's changed a little bit because we're charging.
Great.
If we have two sets of parents, we know they're paying, if you know these are gonna pay, we're really out for hire. I know we talked about no.
Yeah.
I guess that line gets smeary a little bit when somebody comes in and you're not sure.
Well, you can just make it your policy after the enrollment day. If seats are available, then you can open it up to out-of-district students after enrollment day.
Remember, I only have two people in there. If it gets too large.
No, you figure out what that number is.
You still cut it off that number.
You gotta decide what that number is. Tell us what you think that number is.
Whenever you get there, you stop.
You make that decision.
Let me check with Chelsea, because I'm not sure what. Again, it goes back to the earlier conversation, depends a little bit on the makeup of kids, if they're kids with IEPs and others, it might. But I understand, okay, let me visit with her tomorrow about that number and, okay, because we have a couple that are real close, so.
Okay.
But I'm really happy about this.
Yeah.
Compared to where we were when we met the end of July.
I'm afraid we'd be sitting here 6 or 7.
Yeah, exactly. It's great. So I did ask Larry to wait on his hire to replace one of the folks that we have coming over here until after tomorrow night. And then Wednesday, we'll talk about whether or not to go and get that advertised with them to replace that position. Okay?
Any questions? All right, budget review.
Okay. So we spent last week, here's the, if you're interested in some late night reading here, I will supply you on the 28th with a more detailed budget, but I wanted to just give you kind of the down and dirty, and Marcy's sitting here to help me where I make any mistakes. So if you take a look at this first sheet, it's Form 150 at the bottom, and I'm on page 1. The big piece is line 21 that tells you your LOV general fund budget of $4,619,478. And then everything up above is how they came to that total of 18, line 18. If you look at our total operating budget numbers of kids, 1,000, well, FTE, not kids, but all of those different things get a weight. You get a weight for enrollment, a weight for career and tech ed, and a weight for transportation. All of that totals 1,034. They take that times that base state aid of $4,006 to give you 4.143 and some change. Then you add in the special ed cost at the very bottom of 381 to get your 4.6. Are we good?
Is that $381?
I'm sorry, $381,367, yes.
Hold on. You need to clarify that just a little bit. Because line 20 already has your special ed weighting, Michelle.
The 4 point?
Doesn't it?
Well, I thought...
Line 12 is special ed weighting. But what line 21 is about... is that's how they're, that's the LOV, that's what they're saying is our general fund budget. So to figure out our percentage for what our local option budget can be. You know, to figure, we can do a max of 30%.
Right. So that's the...
That's the... And you see that they've got our weighting times 4,490. Remember, they have a different.
So your weighting up here at the top was 1,343 kids. Or the weighting. Not, they don't call it kids, it's just your weighted FTE on line 18. So then on 21, if you look at that 943, is that what you're saying, Marcy?
Yeah, it's 943. So they took out the special ed weighting.
Okay.
And they took it times 4,490 because that was what, from 2008?
Right.
That was the base per pupil aid. And then they're adding in special ed. That's what our special ed budget is.
Right.
I know it's really...
It is confusing. So that's
why... You'll understand that when you get to the LOB.
Which I think I have that one.
Yeah, when you get to LOB and that, you'll think, well, how did they come up with 30% of...
But the important number is that 4.6, right?
The 4.1.
4.1, okay.
20 is, okay.
Line 20.
Okay. The other... pieces, table 3 on page 2, form 150, details out your transportation weighting. Your 402 square mile district, the number of pupils transported for whom 2.5 miles or more. Anything more we would want to say on that one, Marcio?
No, we just talked about, so that $331,272, that's
line 6.
Uh-huh. That's the amount that gets put in the general fund
for transportation.
That's where it goes.
Right. So table 5 on page 3, virtual, we don't have. Got a little information on their free lunch students.
I'm not sure how that's...
So your middle code 99, this is what's going to be published in the paper. Skip it for a minute and then let's look at the budget at a glance. The budget at a glance is what goes on the website and what will provide for a budget hearing as well as the full document. And on page 2, you get a summary of all of our total expenditures in each one of the areas. You've got 16, 17, and 17, 18. Got a graph at the bottom. I wanted you to look at page valuation on page 10. Your assessed valuation is up this year from 36.6 million in 15-16 to 45.3 million in 17-18. So that's nice. Your valuation has gone up. The state predicts that that's going to level out over the course of the next few years. So then I would take you back to your code 99, because everybody wants to know about the taxpayer. On that code 99, this is what will get published in the paper after we go see Gary on Wednesday. And if you look at, see this column here, I'll refer to these numbers right here. So if you look at 08, which is your LOB, the tax rate over the last 3 years, in 15-16 it was 17.2, 16-17 it was 16.5, and this year your tax rate is 16.9. So you're not asking for, you're asking for what would decide, Marcel, about 4/10?
Yeah, I don't know how you got to that.
Nope.
No, about the contingency.
We ended up taking and transferring, because we talked about using some of that contingency money. We took $80,000 and transferred it into the general fund, to supplemental general, to partly help cover and keep this lower. We played around with whatever number it was going to take to keep that from
to keep that mill levy steady.
To keep the mill levy steady without having it raised.
Our state aid for LOB went down.
Right.
Okay, so that's why.
That's why the trade, because
that's my valuation went up. We're working on money, so why is why did our mill levy go up? Most everything else, some various cities, fire departments, everybody else is going down. Mm-hmm. The difference is the state aid was less. Was the state aid took less than what we generated more on taxes,
right.
So that
right.
The difference caused it to us.
And your budget for LOB last year was at $1,314,991. We went ahead and stuck with the full 30%. We assumed you guys wanted to know.
What I assumed more than anything was that you wanted to keep that mill levy pretty steady. Because when we originally started, it had gone, we had it up 2 or 3 mills without making that transfer.
Well, you talked about the last meeting about trying to restore some of the balances too.
Right, yes.
Here for a year or two, what we could, because we've been taking our balances and dropping off quite a bit, our transfer balances each year, the same number.
And you also, the last 2 to 3 years, you've been having us take small maintenance repairs and uniforms and stuff, you've had us take that out of capital outlay.
But we won't now.
We won't. We're trying to get this shifted back to the LOB and keep capital outlay for capital outlay projects.
Make up stuff for what we've been doing over the last 5 or 6 years.
Yeah. In doing that, we're having to take $80,000 out of contingency to try to keep the mill levy
set.
Thanks. I'm going to get your call if you guys want to do something different.
I see nothing out of there at the same point in time to say we're safe to you. You know, if we're not blowing it at the end of the year, but maybe we'll stick one back in.
Mm-hmm, that's right.
That is.
Well, and that's where we've been kind of tossing and turning over the early childhood.
Where to go ahead. To account for it, where to have it covered, and knowing that we were going to incur expenses there, even with the money we're bringing in, we're not generating enough to cover what's needed for that classroom. So where are we going to make up that additional cost out of?
Well, again, it's nice that it comes in contingency for this 1 year until we kind of feel our way through this thing and see where we, if this $100 is going to work or not going to work, or what we have to do to adjust that as the year goes on. for next year.
So it goes to Dale, Marcia and I will take it to Dale Dennis at KSDE, and he'll kind of stamp approval on it, or give us other things to stop and think about or look at, and then I'll come home, provided he doesn't change anything radically, get this sent to the paper and have it published, and then the hearing on the 28th, you might make a note of this. What do you decide, will we be able to set up for that meeting or 14?
No, 14.
Okay. So the 28th, the budget hearing will be at 7:30, which means I got to change this time on this. Sorry, you know, don't we forget.
7:30
on the 28th. 7:30 on the 28th.
So is that all that's going on that night?
On the 28th is only budget hearing. 14th, then, is your regular August board meeting. Would like for you to have a special meeting from 6 to 7 o'clock. That is your goal setting time, time to review the goals that we have had since I've been here and feed you, and then start your regular meeting at 7. This year, the 754 mark. for seal? Okay.
State aid right here, last year we got $556,000.
This year's at its rates.
This year we get $482,000. So that's what we had to make.
So then we made that up from our transfer of contingency.
Yeah. Plus we're going to increase the budget to the 30%.
Authority. Right. Don't panic. You what? Okay, let me make you a copy just so I can marshal it up here. Each one of these, each one of the codes you go through and we solve each one of them at a time. And she always, Marcia always takes me back to that code 99 to look and see what it's going to do to the tax rate. So we put in the revenues and then we put in the expenditures. And that transfer was the only way. If we hadn't made that transfer, we would have gone up another two, almost three mills in our local, in our supplemental.
What's our valuation? $45,000.
$45,370,000. Each mill brings you $45,000, so it would have been about two mills to come roughly close. Which I didn't feel like you all wanted to do very bad. I probably shouldn't have started with that front sheet because that. I'm not. When Dale starts talking about how they get all of those weightings and all of those formulas that are involved in it, and I get confused. So I probably should have just not even done that. Started with that code 99.
Well, no, I just.
Did you guys?
Yeah.
special ed is the same way, right? Did it, does it just have to do with what you start with the general fund and invest anymore? Well, we also want to make sure that we have enough to cover any Medicaid changes, so we're up to that. We don't want to be in the year under the regular payment for special ed.
Right.
And Bonnie asked a question to your, So I'll keep this on the agenda for Monday, as you take stuff home and wanna, if you think of something between now and then, ask me, and I'll try to make sure I can get an answer.
And actually, you noticed on the teacher side, we got another teacher because we didn't fill her job in.
Yeah.
Somebody absorbed. Okay, other questions? So can we review August quickly? 14th, we're gonna have a special meeting from 6 to 7, and we're gonna feed you regularly. 28th, then your budget hearing is at 7:30.